9 important tips on how to choose curtains. Got the furniture and wardrobes and kitchen cabinets for your home? There is one element of home decor that you simply can't ignore: curtains. They are one of those crucial pieces of decor that can set the tone for the room. From light and breezy to substantial and ornamental, from solid colors to prints, from sheer fabrics to heavy opaque textile, the possibilities are endless. With the sheer variety of options for tracks, fabrics, and accessories out there, making the right choice can be quite confusing. Here are a few quick tips on how to choose curtains that could help you. Number 1. Difference between curtains and drapes. Pick curtains for privacy and drapes to block out sunlight. The first step to figuring out how to choose curtains is to figure out what your room requires. Oftentimes, homeowners choose curtains, drapes, blinds, and shades without knowing the difference. Doing so, these window treatments can actually interfere with the amount of sunlight your room should get. Curtains are fabric panels made of light materials and hang from curtain rods. They are mostly used for privacy purposes, making them perfect for living rooms. Whereas drapes are made of thicker materials that are meant to block out sunlight, making them ideal for bedrooms. Number 2. Pick out the right fabric materials can change the tone of the design. The material plays a vital role in the look of the curtains and consequently the room. From sheerless to lightweight cotton, medium-weight brocades to heavy velvet, your options are aplenty. The two factors that you should consider while picking your fabric are the amount of sunlight you want streaming in, the mood and decor of your room. For example, heavier fabrics suit more traditional rooms, while sheer fabrics work best in more minimalistic rooms. Remember, each fabric falls differently from an elevation and therefore will look different when pleated and drawn back. Number 3. The choice of color can make or break the look. Curtains should complement the furnishings in the room. The color of your curtains should ideally be in sync with the rest of the furnishings. You could either choose drapes that harmonize with the decor or contrast with it. For a pleasing look, choose drapes in a color that complement the shade of your walls. Alternatively, if you want the curtain colors to be the focus, pick a hue that contrasts with the furniture and walls. Number 4. Choosing between prints and solids, opt for patterns. When the room is packed with solid colors, to answer this, we need to look at the rest of the decor. If all the other soft furnishings in the room are a solid color, going with printed curtains can be a popular choice. The opposite holds true as well. One thing to remember is that prints add visual weight to any element. Therefore, one way to work with printed curtains is to pair them with solid colored furniture accessorized with printed cushions, area rugs, etc. You could use quirky prints and geometric patterns with contemporary style space, while florals would suit modern, classic, and traditional decor. Number 5. Selecting the ideal length floor. Length curtains give the appearance of a high ceiling room. Curtains that fall exactly to the floor level are in vogue. For a more dramatic look, you can opt for a certain size that is longer by a few inches so that the drapes puddle on the floor. On the other hand, if you have kids, you are better off with curtains a couple of inches above the floor. Ending them at the sill for smaller windows is yet another classic option, but full length drapes could work equally well. Number 6. Measuring the width. Get drapes that are wide for a neat and gathered look. The ideal width of your curtains depends on the width of the molding of your window pane or drawer. One way to arrive at the ideal width is to measure the frame and multiply it by a factor of 2 or 2.5. The extra fabric helps accomplish the gathered look on the sides when the curtains are drawn back. Number 7. Trims and accessories. Curtains tie backs are a great way to spruce up the design, dress them up, or tone them down. Trims and accessories for curtains range from pullbacks and valances to ornamental curtain, tracks fixed on the wall above the curtains. Trims and accessories can be cleverly accompanied with light tabs to add richness and grandeur. Valance, the decorative frilled fabric placed at the top of the window, is an excellent way to add embellishment to your room. On the other hand, simply pull backs and the absence of decorative trims will make fabrics like velvet or satin look chic and slick. This again will depend on the effect you want to achieve. Number 8. Picking between lined and unlined curtains. Depths with curtain lining give you privacy and allow sufficient sunlight to enter the room. Here is where you weigh the functionality of the curtains or depth that you have chosen. If the curtain hangs on a window that receives direct sunlight, a protective lining can make it more opaque, fade slower and last longer. Also, two layers, one sheer, one opaque, can you give the flexibility to choose the amount of privacy and light you want. The fact remains that a lining makes depth heavier, so choose wisely. Number 9. Select fabric based on the maintenance required. Drapes with stitch pleats and swags must be dry cleaned. The fabric and material of a curtain determine how it should be cleaned and how often you need to clean it. While all curtains and drapes should be washed every 3 to 6 months, there are some fabrics that require more care and some that can be machine washed. Low maintenance fabrics. If you are looking for curtains that need to be washed twice a year, opt for cotton or synthetic fabrics. This can be machine washed if they are unlined, or else give them your lined curtains a quick hand wash. A great option for those with dust allergies or kids and pets at home. High maintenance fabrics. Any curtain that has pleats or swags must be dry cleaned regardless of the fabric. However, wool, silk and sheer curtains must be dry cleaned or hand washed in cold water to retain their colors and shape. You can also choose to vacuum your drapes and curtains on a weekly basis if you are prone to dust allergies. It's always best to factor in curtains while you are deciding the rest of the decor of your room. Consequently, your decor will be more coordinated and harmonious. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up and share it with your friends. For getting more useful and interesting information, to subscribe to the Engineer Ajay Lars channel, How to Make Home.